But Doreen, I only...
All I said was you give me a pain, and he jumps to conclusions and starts yelling the place down.
Darling, naturally, if you mention the word pain,
I must assume... There are all sorts of pains.
Well, of course there are all sorts of pains.
Major Buckling, I've had just about as much as I can stand. If Mr. Pitchford isn't kept downstairs, I won't be answerable for the consequences.
But, Essie, I only do what I'm trying...
Dougal, run downstairs and see if you can find something for Doreen to read. There's a good boy.
Yes, do, Dougal, dear. And Dougal.
Yes, darling?
Don't hurry back.
Now, Becky, this is the end.
Don't. If I had a father, he'd horsewhip you. You took advantage of being a lot of helpless females.
That's a lie. The place is teeming with men.
Stop that racket.
Don't call me a liar.
Will you be quiet?
If there was half a man amongst you, you'd throw him out.
If he was half a man, he'd throw himself out.
Oh, don't worry. I'm going.
Oh, Rowley, no. Oh, Rowley. I'll throw myself under a tree.
Well, does it mean anything to you that someone's trying to have a baby in this house? Or are you too self-centered to care?
Oh, you keep out of it. Catherine, he says he's never going to see me again.
Make him give it to you in writing.
Oh, Rowley.
Oh, she's mad. You're been locked up.
You can't.
Oh, we just stop it.
Come on,
what
have I done?
You beast. You beast. You little beast.
Cut it out, will you?
Can't you shut up, you maniac?
Vicky, stop this nonsense at once. Get up,
those
hot. How dare you, Vicky? I'm ashamed of you.
As if she cares. Life's greatest mystery about to happen at any moment, and all people do is to roll around the floor and break up the furniture.